Franklin in New York Sports Now, Dan Mardell. Our special report on Knicks point guard number 17, Jeremy Lin, and the Linsanity surrounding him. Now, despite the Knicks' loss in New Orleans, the Big Apple is still in the middle of a Jeremy Linvasion. Fellas, do you have Linsanity?
Hey, you better lock me up. I mean, I am criminally Linsane.
Oh, yeah.
My feelings are Lintense.
It's Lindescribable. I mean, I am literally Lin Love with this Jeremy Lin.
We can all agree we'll never get tired of Lin puns.
Well, as Charlie Sheen would say, linen.
That's another thing we never got tired of. Yeah. Now, with all the talk swirling around Lin, some of the discussion has gotten racially charged. We've seen derogatory comments from Fox Sports' Jason Whitlock and ESPN.com. The bottom line is, the kid's a great basketball player, and race has nothing to do with it. As the New York Post says, he's amazing.
Hilarious.
Hilarious.
I said it better myself.
Hilarious. I mean, he's unstoppable. He's like that sign said at Wednesday's game, Lin is the Knicks' good fortune.
He's sweet, not sour.
He turned Kobe into Kobe beef.
Yeah. And Kobe's like, hey, I ordered fried chicken.
Hey, yo, what's up with that, man? What's up with all that, bro? What's
don't
up
say
with
chicken.
All that, yo?
No, don't say chicken.
Come on, Joe. Joe, leave race out of this. Fellas, Jeremy Lin had some amazing moments this week. What were some of your favorite Lincidences?
Well, I'd say it was in the fourth quarter against the Lakers. Lin goes to the corner and me love you long time sinks a three.
Hey, I gotta say Knicks Raptors last Tuesday. 5 seconds left, Lin goes to the top of the key and wax on, wax off, Mr. Miyagi. Game winning shot. Absolutely. I'd pick the Knicks-Kings when Lin passed it to Amare Stoudemire. Stoudemire was dancing like Maury Povich just told him, you are not the father.
Yo, what's up with all that? What's up with all that, man? He was not dancing.
I'm finding the line.
If he was, I bet he was saying, domo arigato, Mr. Linbato.
Now that's funny. That's funny.
Now, switching gears for a moment, it's Black History Month. Let's take a moment to honor a great African-American athlete.
Jackie Robinson, an amazing athlete who broke down barriers. Robinson endured name-calling and racial taunts, but he persevered. And that's why today the sports world is tolerant.
We're still in the Lin Dynasty. New York Sports Now caught up with Jeremy Lin last Tuesday. Let's take a look.
Yeah, we talked about...
Ha ha. It was a great honor to throw the ball today. The court was large and the men tall like stones. Ha! Soon we battle Dallas and I will try my tiger claw technique. Go!
Oops. So switch the audio. That person will be reprimanded.
You know, I think there's something glaring that we are all overlooking. I mean, what's gonna happen when Carmelo Anthony comes back?
He likes that Chinese in his MSG. See what I did there?
Yeah, I saw it. I saw that.
Hey, Carmelo's gonna see Lin in the locker room and be like, excuse me, are we playing ping pong here?
Well, he may not see him at all because my homie Carmelo rolls in late.
Yo, hey! Let me tell you one more time.
Hey!
One more time.
That's extremely offensive.
Yeah, the notion that an African-American man are late for work is an outdated and ignorant stereotype.
True.
I'm sorry, I thought we were having that kind of fun. Dan, back me up.
Apologize to our viewers at home for the comments of Joe Dixon. They were Lin-sensitive and politically Lin-correct. He has been fired. In return, we'll talk Jeremy Lin with comedian Don Rickles and a crotchety World War II veteran. Live from New York, it's Saturday Night!